Pelata Gatti with the Kori Ajadina gravy. Oh, I love this combination.
I love this pulav. I love the flavors of this pulav.
We're in the heart of Bengaluru and we are here to partake of a very special culinary experience that seeks to emulate what it would feel like to dine at a Bengaluru home. I'm here at Bengaluru Oota Company, a delicious culinary venture born out of two individuals' passion for their native fare. So let's go in and explore their story and also eat some delicious oota. Let's go.
Hello. Nice to be here.
Lovely to have you here.
Thank you for having us over. You feel like you've entered someone's home. This is so special as a dining experience. So I'm here with Divya, Prabhakar, who's one of the co-owners of Bengaluru Oota Company. So when you conceived of Bengaluru Oota Company, what was the idea? What was the thought?
So the first thing was that we wanted people to actually have access to local regional food.
Okay.
And this is something that's across the country where we don't really showcase enough of it. So the idea was to showcase at least two of these cuisines because these are our ancestral recipes. So I'm the Gowda and Vishal is the Mangalorean.
The Mangalorean. Hi Vishal, how are you?
Hi.
So this is Vishal Shetty, the other co-owner or the other half of the Bengaluru Oota Company. And so that's a fascinating combination. So you bring Gowda food and you bring Mangalorean food. I mean, that's interesting. I mean, that's a combo that...
is interesting also because...
So do they complement?
They do.
Okay.
It's surprisingly interesting because when you go through your meal experience, you notice that each course is specific to a region and then the next one complements into that.
So if you were to describe Gowda cuisine, let's say in one line, what would that be?
The Gowda food is something that we're ancestrally a farming community.
Yes.
Though not many of us are into that anymore. But the food is typically what we've grown over the years. And also livestock includes mutton and chicken, so they're more mutton lovers. Chicken follows next. Seafood's not part of our repertoire.
That's right.
We have some things which are very unique to this because we use a lot of garlic, we use a lot of coriander in different forms. We use dhania powder literally in everything.
Yes. So the food is very ruddy, very robust
and
supposed to...
it's more browns and greens. It's very earthy colors.
Very, also. That's right. And then, of course, Mangalorean food is the other end of the spectrum altogether.
Yes, when you think Mangalorean, you're only looking at seafood mainly. There's a whole, because again, we are from the coastal region.
Yes.
And we use a lot of Bedige chilies in our curry. So it's a fiery red color that you would see in our curry.
Yes.
And but it's not very spicy or hot, but just the color because of the chilies that we use. And again, primarily, we love our meats. So a Mangalorean can start off with the breakfast with the non-vegetarian and
go all the way up to dinner.
All the way down, yes.
Absolutely, yeah. Great. So I've never really tasted Gowda food and Mangalorean food on the same plate. So this is going to be a very special experience for me as well. And I can't really wait to get to the table and taste all that food. Yeah. So I think on that note, we should probably make our way into the kitchen and see what's cooking.
Yes.
Here at Bengaluru Oota Company. So this is the blackboard menu for the day.
Yes, right. Your table.
For my table. So you typically would customize the menu depending on the guests?
That's right.
Okay. So when I look at this menu here, I can see, so there's one, two, so that, of course you got the KOSAMBARI, goli bhaji and the Kane Fry.
So this is Karnataka.
Karnataka.
This is Mangalorean, this is Mangalorean.
See, okay.
Mangalorean. We also do stuff which is seasonal.
Okay.
So currently Pelata Gatti is seasonal.
Okay.
Jackfruit's in season, it's going to end by the end of this month. So we try and ensure that people experience.
So Pelata is jackfruit.
That's right.
I like the fact that even the terminology that you've used is very local, very ethnic.
So the idea is to educate people on the food and also what it's rightly called.
And all these dishes are served course by course.
That's right.
All right.
Each one comes out by itself because it's all made freshly at that point. We don't reheat anything. So it's given in time for you to have lunch.
Oh, wonderful.
So there's no menu. So when you, so let's say if a guest were to come here, he would call ahead and he would, and you would ask him or her what they would like to eat.
People have to book minimum of a day in advance.
Minimum of a day in advance.
And so the reason being that we started off by, Vishu hates wasting food, which is right. Huh. I hate anything that's frozen or refrigerated. And therefore, this is the format that works best for
wow.
us. So we know how many people are coming in. And then based on what's freshly available and what allergies they've mentioned, we put together the menu and we buy everything every morning.
So what would this be priced at?
So it so we don't have any fixed pricing because it also depends on what we buy, the ingredients at what price we buy it at.
Okay.
So a menu like this would be in the region of about 1400 to 1500 rupees.
Alright, per person. Alright.
Tax per person.
Alright, fantastic. So now that I've seen the menu, really can't wait to get to the table and savor all of this. But I think we should take a quick peek into the kitchen and see what's cooking up here at the Bengaluru Oota Company. Can we come in?
Hi.
Hello.
Welcome to my kitchen.
Oh, lovely. I can see you've got the kani that's getting
that's right.
ready.
Part of your lunch menu today.
Lovely. So do you get a certain size of kani?
Yes. So we try not to bring pick up the really large ones because we have a very extensive menu. So the idea is that people flavor each of these dishes but don't necessarily pack off before they hit dessert and coffee.
So you want people to savor and enjoy each course.
Menu, so this is a very traditional recipe from Mangalore.
Okay.
Pelata Gatti. Traditionally, it's wrapped in teakwood leaves, but I'm here. I'm putting using my idli molds.
Your idli
it's,
molds.
Jackfruit, ripe jackfruit, and we serve it with a savoury chicken curry.
So that comes with the chicken today.
That's right.
So the people that I see working here are not typical cooks or chefs as you.
No. So we chose to work with a lot of women who primarily cook at home, and
okay.
they learned from their mothers and their grandmothers and their aunts, and they're all from in and around. So they have the flavor of the local food.
Ah, okay.
So that's very important for us.
Nice. All that aroma. Beautiful. So I'm going to leave you to the cooking and I'm going to...
We'll soon put it out on your LA.
I'll be waiting.
Yes.
Thank you. As I sit here waiting for my meal to commence, I can smell all the aromas that are wafting from the kitchen. I can hear the pressure cooker whistling away. It's just a happy feeling that you get when you're at someone's home. You're at the dining table and you smell all sorts of delicious aromas emanating from the kitchen. I can't wait for this meal to commence.
Welcome to
you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
You can open your leaf.
Okay.
Clean, so you don't have to worry about washing it.
All right. Excellent. So our meal at Bengaluru Oota Company has well begun. This feels nice and cool to the touch. There's nothing like eating with your fingers, and that's a philosophy that Bengaluru Oota Company also propagates. You've got that fresh crunch with the cucumber and just the right amount of tempering that's gone into it that gives it that slightly savoury lift. This is a moist KOSAMBARI. It's just been prepared. Just the perfect start. I'm going to have some of this garlic sandige. Scoop up that KOSAMBARI with that garlic sandige. So you've got that scrumptious crunch of the sandige, the fritter, and then you have that juicy crunch, that juicy bite of the cucumber. I think our meal at Bengaluru Oota Company has begun just on the right note. I can't wait for the other dishes to arrive now.
So this is the second thing on your menu. It's called the Goli Bache. It's a Mangalorean street side snack.
Very lovely.
Popular. It's a tea time snack also, but it's one of our hot favorites.
Hot favorites. A Mangalore speciality. Oh, this feels, this is hot to the touch. So it's crisp outside, but just so yielding inside. Mmm. Fried food always tastes great. And this one, even more so. So you've got that scrumptious, crunchy skin encasing the porous goli bhaji. Take the goli bhaji with a generous dollop of the chutney. Mmm. The fresh coconut, the chili in that, the chili hit in that chutney just goes so well with the mellow. Oh, I just bit into a piece of chili. That's a spirited chutney. It's got that coconut and it's got that chili. And that with the mellow flavors of the goli bhaji works so well. Mmm. It's spicy, but does enough to whet your appetite for the courses that follow. So this is a Kane Rava Fry.
Yes.
So the Kane has to be one of my favorite fish. And I love the size of this Kane. It's not too big, neither is it too small. Feels hot and there's this... So it's a Rava Fried Kane. So you've got the Rava encasing the fish, and in between the rava and the fish, you can see the masala. Mmm. You can taste the flaky freshness of the fish. So good. The minimal crumbed texture that's encasing the masala in this fish. And they all come together so well. The masala just has the right amount of spicing. You don't want the masala to overpower the fish. You want the masala to allow the flavor of the fish to shine through, and that's what this does. So the light rava coating and that masala just allows the gentle flavors of the Kane, the lady fish, to shine through. This fish is beautifully prepared. Mmm. This is so good.
Kaima, which is a very typical Gowda dish.
We've tasted the Karnataka Kosambari, we've tasted the Mangalore Bhaji, we've tasted the Kane Rava Fry. Now we're moving on to the Gowda side of things with the Kaima Unde. So soft to the touch. Mmm, that literally melts in your mouth. You don't need to chew on this at all. It's just got that slightly crunchy bottom that you see right here. And then you've got all this coriander flavored mutton mince. Mmm. I love the fresh flavors of the coriander that comes through in this Kaima Unde. This wasn't part of our menu, but it comes as a happy surprise. This is so good. Mm. I can certainly smell all the jackfruit that's in this. This is going to be an interesting bite. Mmm. So imagine you're tucking into an idli, and in that idli you've got suddenly this sweetness that emerges from flecks of jackfruit. So it's not a cloying sweetness, it's that gentle lingering sort of a flavor. Oh, this is, I've never tasted this before. This is called a Pelata Gatti. Pelata means jackfruit in Tulu, and Gatti is come together. So I've got my Kori Ajadina, which is, I presume, a coconut based. Get some chicken on the bone. Fry the Pelata Gatti with the Kori Ajadina gravy. Oh, I love this combination. So you have that gentle sweetness from the Pelata Gatti, and then you have the robust spicing of the Kori Ajadina, and then you taste all the coconut flakes that are there at Ajadina gravy. Oh, this is delightful. I've got a piece of the chicken that I've now mixed into my Pelata Gatti, just so that I make a nice big mouthful. This is so good.
It's a very seasonal dish when the jackfruit is in season. So everyone come back for it, asking for it.
Yes. And I also like the way this chicken is prepared. It's cooked just right. It's not some stringy piece of chicken that you have to struggle with. And the chicken has absorbed all the flavors of the masala. This is so good.
It was now time for the main course, beginning with the hearty Bannur Mamsa Pulav.
This, have a bite of just the rice, so you get the flavor of the pulav.
Okay.
The second bite, have this pudina chutney.
All right.
So that gives you a zing.
Okay.
Third bite, have the pudina chutney and the pachadi.
When do I get to the meat?
The meat is there, you can.
Okay. All right.
And you can add the munchi kori after a couple of bites, so that gives you another zing.
So this is the main course here at Bengaluru Oota Company. I've got this aromatic Bannur Mamsa Pulav. The meat and the rice that's cooked together, it all comes together. The flavors of the meat, the flavors of the spices, the fresh herbs that would have gone into it. And with a pulav, you will always find that the rice and the meat clumps together. They come together in that happy union. So it's not like you will find every grain of rice separate, every piece of meat separate. This is a happy union of the rice and the meat, which is what makes for a delicious pulav. I'm going to taste the rice in this Bannur Mamsa Pulav first. You know, the rice feels warm to the touch. You can taste the fresh flavors of the coriander and all the other masalas that have gone into this. The rice is so flavorful. And it also has a slightly sour twang, perhaps from some lemon that's drizzled over the pulav just as it is finished. So Divya here says, try the chutney with the pulav and bit of the pachadi too on the side. So Divya is making me work hard before I get to the meat. Well, when you're dining at someone's home, you got to play by their rules. And that's what we're going to do. I'm going to take a bit of that chutney with my pulav rice. It's all come together into one flavorful bite. It takes it in a whole new direction. So when I was tasting just the rice from the pulav, it was mellow, it was fresh in its flavors, and then when you taste it with the mint chutney, it just kind of spirits it off into a whole new direction from a flavor perspective. I love this pulav. I love the flavors of this pulav. You can see the strands of onions. You can see the greens, that is the coriander. Copious amounts of it, I'm sure, that's gone into this. Get a nice piece of meat right here. Oh. The meat certainly has some bite to it. You feel that as you even break into the meat. I'm going to taste the meat now with the rice. And you taste all those flavors together. So take a bit of fat, take a bit of the meat, because the fat has all the flavor. So you take all of that, get a bit of rice, work a bit of the rice into it, and that'll give you a flavorful mouthful. Some pachadi. I love the yogurt in this pachadi. It's nice and thick. And creamy. I'm going to help myself now to a bit of the munchi kori or the
chili chicken. So the chili chicken is served as a side with the pulao. So I think the chicken is braised in a onion masala, and although the name says chili chicken, I was bracing myself for a lot of heat, but actually it's quite gentle in its flavor. You know, with chicken you always need masalas, you need spices, you need gravies that are flavorful, because that helps lift the chicken, and that's what this Kori Munchi masala does. It just lifts the flavor of the chicken. I think this rice has all the flavor, and I think that's the character of a pulao that's well made. You know, there's a sort of happy osmosis that happens between the meat and the rice, where the meat imparts all its flavors to the rice while it's being cooked. So you've got the rice which has all the flavor of the meat. So if you were to ask me frankly, I could eat this pulao just by itself, even without the mutton. Of course, the meat is always a happy bonus, and you have something that you can bite into. So you have this boiled egg, it's boiled, sliced into half, and then tossed in a pan. So the skin has that firm touch to it. Pan roasted boiled egg with the pulao. It's always nice to get a bit of fiber in between your meal. And now you have the avocado, which is a very local vegetable. I think it's a bean of sort. There's the avocado, the bean, and then there's coconut, there's curry leaf. Now what I like about those vegetables is that the vegetables still retain their crunch or provide you that healthy interlude in between tasting all that meat. And I also like the bite of the coconut that you taste in this vegetable. Some rasam to just help settle things down. It's a tangy rasam, low on spice but high on the tang. You know, my plate looks like a happy mess, but it's a happy mess that results from a lot of happy eating that's happened on this table right here. And of course, now I have my curd rice.
Yes.
So all meals in Namma Uru, I think most of South India, has to end with the curd rice or the mosaranna out here. And this mosaranna also has pomegranate seeds, so it looks all the more interesting and colorful. And this is a mensakai, and this mensakai is made of pineapple. You know, after all the hot dishes that we ate, this feels cool and refreshing even before you put it in your mouth. You have that pop of the pomegranate and that tiny little burst of sweetness that comes from the pomegranate seeds. I can also taste the curry leaves that have gone into this mosaranna. It's been lightly tempered. I think the curry leaf has been roasted, so you get that sort of roasted curry leaf flavor as well. I'm going to taste the mensakai just by itself first. I'm going to taste the mensakai with the curd rice, and this is going to be an interesting bite. So you got that creaminess of the curd rice, then you got the sharp acidic flavor that comes from the pineapple, and you got that mellow lingering heat from the mensakai. It's such a happy combination of flavors and textures in your mouth. So the banana leaf is now closed. Time to wash my hands and come back for the dessert and coffee.
Badam Halwa and filter coffee.
Oh, lovely. I love the airy froth. Oh, look at this. There's a layer of air between the coffee and the froth. And now the froth will go pop. That was an unexpected pop, but a pop nonetheless. This is the sort of coffee that you need to finish your meal. And I'm going to finish my meal with this Badam Halwa. This is again a homemade Badam Halwa. I can feel the dense richness of the Badam Halwa even on the spoon. The nuts that you can taste, of course, the badam, the cashew, goes this ghee that goes into it to bring it all together, and then you have that khoa, the milk solids. That's a look of happiness. See that sweetness of the halwa that gets cut by the rich roasted tones of the coffee. This is a great South Indian filter coffee. So this has been a delicious experience here at Bengaluru Oota Company. Each dish leaves an impression with its own character, personality, in terms of the flavors, in terms of the textures that shine through. I think what makes a meal at Bengaluru Oota Company truly special is the fact that you don't feel restricted by the conventions of a restaurant. You don't feel restricted by the fact that you've got to enter the space and order off a menu in a structured fashion and leave as soon as you finish with the meal. At Bengaluru Oota Company, you get the feeling that you can linger on, because after all, you're not dining in a commercial space, you're not dining in a restaurant, you're dining in someone's home. And it's a treat to chat with the owners, Divya and Vishal, to see their passion for this creative culinary enterprise shine through, not just in terms of the food that they share with you, but also in the delightful stories that the dishes, that the space has to tell. All in all, Bengaluru Oota Company is definitely an experience that one must savor if you are here in Namma Bengaluru. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the Support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!